going down the highway on trucks, but this here's the first time I've seen them that big on them windmills. That is a big fab. Let me see you put that in it. Bedroom window, that'd cool off the whole, that'd blow the house away. The hell, it's just cooling off the house. That there's a big old fan. I wonder if it's a member of Facebook. Be a fan on Facebook. We gone. Bye bye. Okay. This here is GrampaTruckinutts, and yesterday I went to a store and they had these shirts because they're getting rid of the summer collection of clothes. Let's see if I can find a name on that. David Taylor collection. This is this one. But, they had these shirts on sale because they're short sleeves and they're for the summer. But, you know what? I wear short sleeve shirts in the wintertime also. And so, there was a couple of them I know I was going to end up, I probably end up ruining one of them. So, I ended up getting two of these, and two of these. The rest of them, the red, burgundy one there, I got one. There's a blue one there, I got one. The blue pinstripe, I got one. And this one, I got one. I should have got two of those. I like that. This one I got one, and that one I got one. But there's 14 shirts. And all I spent was $45.62. You can see they're all brand new. They still got tags on them. This shirt originally sold for, they had it marked down to $8.99, but originally it was, put the camera down, David. Alright, anyway. Originally, it's a $16.99 shirt. And this one that I like over here with the flowers on it was originally $18.99. This one right here was originally $18.99. It's a silk shirt. I like it. I like the looks of it. Those, they feel like they're army, they're nice and heavy. They're army colored, army shirt green, army green, whatever. But they're nice and heavy. And I like that green one there, this one. But, and I love this burgundy one. Let me get out the light here. It's kind of an Indian red. Anyway, I think that's like the first time in a few years I've been able to buy myself something. And I told my wife that finally getting out of debt, I'm not getting out of debt, but I'm finally being able to get a handle on things. So I'm going to tell her we're each going to get $250 to go spend on clothes. It's raining. I'm in a rest area right now over here in Iowa. since they have free internet connection, I decided to pull off and get out of the rain for a minute and upload a video. As you can see in the mirror, I'm still doing that oversized load on my way out there to California. Anyway, here's GrampaTruckinutts. And as soon as that video is done loading, it's at, or is it 74%. And I'll check it out once and get out of this rest area. Anyway, we're gonna go back to trucking. Here's GrampaTruckinutts. We gone. Bye bye.
Well, halfway across Nebraska on Interstate 80, on my way to California, and I've always wanted to stop up here and see what this thing is about, but I never have. I see the eagle wings up on top. Silver eagle wings. The Great Platte River Road Archway Monument. That's what this is. Wanted to go fishing over there in that lake, pond, river, whatever you want to call it. A lot of things I don't get to do when I'm driving this truck. Oh well. Time to get back to work, I guess. I'm still doing the oversized load. You can see it in the mirror. Still on my way to California. Today's Sunday, September 26th, and the year is 2010. If anybody would have told me 33 years ago that I'd be doing an oversized load going to California 33 years from then, I would have told them they were crazy. If anybody would have told me I'd be 53 years old and still driving truck, I'd have told them they were crazy. That was 25, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. Let's see, when I first got on a truck, I was 15 years old with a guy by the name of Doug. We was with North American Van Lines, and we was pulling 38 foot Kentucky double drop trailer, round nose, and I don't think it was 13 feet 6 inches tall, because shortly after I got on the truck with Doug, trailers became 40 feet 13 6 tall, and big and long and square and whatever, rectangular, and you can fit a lot of stuff in them. A lot more than you could fit in that 38 foot Kentucky double drop we had. And the Mac, it was a single drive axle Mac. I think it had like a 190, I don't know, it was a Detroit, 190 Detroit. 190 Cummins, a little tiny motor. Alright, my camera battery is about to die, so I guess this video is done for now. This is GrampaTruckinutts, and we headed westbound and down. We gone, bye bye. Truck stop, and as you can see, there's a truck right there, but if you look right there, I don't know what them are, deer? Right here in front of me. Two of them. Looks like a male and a female. Wow. Oh, there's two more right there. Running right there. Maybe we can get rid of that beam of light. There's four of them out there. There is two more out there by the fence. Oh boy, there's one standing up on a rock pile. Damn it. Okay. Oh well, I'm still at the Flying J in Rawlins, and got to get some fuel so I can do my trucking. I'm still doing that oversized load on my way to California. I need to wash this window too. I can fit through here. GrampaTruckinutts, we gone. Bye bye.
Cheers, Grampa. GrampaTruckinutts, we out here in Wendover, Nevada, and we're still doing the oversized load.
We're on our way to California, and only got 500 and some odd miles left. Yesterday I went and bought, had to spend $1,000 for four new tires, almost $1,100. It seems my trailer needs an alignment, because the tires was wearing kind of screwy on the inside edges. And if you can look right here, you can see that the top tire right there and the top tire over there was wearing kind of screwy, and these ones on the bottom started to wear a little screwy. So my trailer needs an alignment. I'm just doing my little walk around inspection, making sure everything's still secure. Everything was looking good, so this here's GrampaTruckinutts. We at the Pilot in Wendover, Nevada. Yeah, we gonna get ready to go trucking. We gone, bye-bye. Yeah, I just noticed this son of a bitch. I wanted to get a picture of him. See how big he is, that's my finger. Damn it. I don't like this. You zoom in and then stuff gets blurry. I'm out here in Wyoming. Rawlins, Wyoming. I just went inside and had me some coffee, and in the restaurant where you come out to pay for your check, there's a cooler. Last night when I went in, I did not go in the restaurant. I just went into the store to see if they had any Bud Light with lime. And damn it, it's cold. Anyway, in the restaurant where you pay for your check, there's a cooler, and jumped right out at me all them cartons, cases of Bud Light with lime. I'm like, damn it, I didn't see that last night. Makes me wish I'd have gone into the restaurant now, but that's okay. I had Bud Light with lime in the fridge anyway. Oh well. This is GrampaTruckinutts. It's a new day. We got to do it all over again, just like we did yesterday. We gone. Bye-bye.